Welcome back to the channel where we discuss everything low-code, no-code, AI, and automation. Today, we're going to show you how to build your own AI content writer using two tools, Froala and Replit. By the end of this video, you'll be able to prompt your way to a beautiful web application where you can write content for your blog, your website, your YouTube channel, and so much more. You'll have powerful tools like inline editing, bolding text, added images and videos, and tables, all made possible through the Replit integration that we're gonna install right into Replit. This only takes a few minutes to get up and running, and we'll show you how everything works, so stick through to the end of the video. If you like this video, be sure to give it a thumbs up. Subscribe to our channel so you don't miss any other videos like this one. And if you have any comments about what we did, drop them below and we'll get back to you. Okay, let's go ahead and dive in and show you how this all works. Okay, before we jump in and show you the application that we built with Froala and Replit, which is an AI content writer, I just want to talk a little bit about Froala, what it is, and how you can get started with it. So what it is a WYSIWYG, or what you see is what you get, HTML editor that's simple to use. It's a low-code solution, but with AI dev agents, it's really no-code because you can just prompt your way into getting Froala up and running whatever your tech stack is. So they support a lot of different tech stacks, JavaScript, React. If you're using WordPress, no problem with Froala. But as you can see, there's other frameworks as here, like Ember JavaScript, Knockout JavaScript, Meteor JavaScript, and so much more. It's usually just a couple of lines of code to get up and running. And then you can have this beautiful HTML editor in your tech stack. And today we're gonna combine that with OpenAI and actually integrate a button into the Froala editor that allows us to write with AI and then enhance the writing with Froala's features. Looking at some internal cases, you could build content management systems, knowledge bases or wikis, email template builders, internal app comments or notes, product documentation. On the external side, you could build customer support portals, user generated content or blogs, e-commerce product descriptions, support and help request forms. And for the example that we're gonna do today, we are gonna show you how to build an AI content writer. And this would be for an internal use case. But what it would allow you to do is harness the power of ChatGPT within the Froala editor, but then use Froala's powerful features to add images, tables, editing, spacing, and so much more. And I'm gonna show you how this all works. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna head on over to Replit. And if you haven't used Replit before, it's a developer agent. So what does that mean? You basically give the developer agent a prompt, and then the agent will go out and build the application based on your specifications. So let's take a look at our prompt here, and I'll paste this below in the show notes so that you can use this prompt if you would like. We say a single page web application that combines AI powered content generation with rich text editing using the Froala editor and ChatGPT integration as described in the Froala blog post. So what we did is we actually passed in this URL, which is a blog post on the Froala website about how to use the power of ChatGPT right within Froala. So we just pass that in, and then the AI will have some understanding of that. And then we put in some core features like a rich text editor powered by Froala with formatting capabilities, AI content generation using ChatGPT API, and so much more. And then what's going to happen is Replit is actually going to go out and build this based upon our prompt here. And then we can, of course, edit it and tweak it how we would like. But let's go ahead and give this a try and see what happens when we hit start building. So Replit is going to take in all the context of this prompt. It's going to try to understand what we want, and then it's going to come back to us with a proposal of what to build. We can accept it, deny it, or add features, but let's just see what happens here. It's gonna create a plan, and it's gonna actually understand that we're trying to connect with the Froala CDN so that it will pull in all the information that it needs to make this working in our app. So we see everything here. It very quickly gave us a proposal. We could add different content templates and presets, implement content collaboration features, use advanced AI writing. We're gonna skip all this. We can always do this later. So all we have to do is hit approve plan and start. Now, this is gonna take a few minutes. Generally, you know, 5 to 10 minutes for it to build this app. But remember, it is coding this app from scratch for us. And it's first gonna give us a visual preview, then an interactive prototype. So Let's let this run and then we'll come back in about 5 to 10 minutes and show you how this all works. And then we'll make sure that we get ChatGPT working inside of the Froala editor. Okay, we'll be right back. Okay, so we're back. That took about 7 minutes. And check this out. We have a application. It's a single page application, very simple, but also very powerful here with the Froala editor loaded right into the application. As you can see, the Froala editor looks super nice, which is one of the really liked features about this product is it's super clean, it's easy to use, and it's fully responsive. So in the Replit staging environment here, if we click up here in the right, we can change our screen size. And let's just change this to an iPhone SE and check this out. It looks really good on all different screen sizes. We could go to a Pixel 7, slightly different screen size, but it's fully responsive without us having to do anything. So I just wanted to point that out, that Froala is fully responsive out of the box. As we can see, we have this rich text editor. It's in a draft state, it's powered by Froala. And over here, down at the bottom, we have our word count, our character count, and the fact that it was auto-saved. So let's go ahead and start typing and say, this is a test. All right, great. So we're able to type that in here. We can highlight the text. We can bold it. We can italicize it. We can underline it. We can change the alignment if we would like to centered or left. We can insert links to our text. So all these really powerful document editing features right here within Froala. I do see that we have an AI button, which has been integrated right into the Froala editor per our prompt. We'll have to connect our OpenAI key for this to work, and we'll give that a try here in a minute, but it looks like it already created the button, which is super, super cool. A couple other things I wanna show you just about the Froala editor in general. We have the ability to add text and styling to the text and links, but we can also do really cool things that sometimes ChatGPT has trouble doing. So let's imagine we create a blog post with AI and the Froala editor, but then we want to insert a table into our blog post. We can easily do that here by just hitting insert table. We can choose the sort of dimensions of our table, and it's going to put this right into our editor for us. So on the fly, we can add rich elements into our post that was created with AI. Same thing with images. We can easily just click insert image. If we go over to the Froala page, let's just copy this image URL. We can come back here, we can paste it in, and we actually put this image inside a cell block, which I didn't mean to do, but you'll see now that we are clicking on the image, we can change the dimensions, we can make it 500 pixels, for instance, and this is gonna update automatically. Let me take it outside of the cell block here because I think that was restricting the size. Yes, it was. So now we can go ahead and change it back to 200, and our image is correctly resized. We can delete it, we can link it, we can change the alignment, and so on and so forth. So really nice. What you see is what you get, rich text editor. And our application also allows us to export this as HTML, plain text, PDF. This is super nice and allows us to quickly spin up documents, write them, export it. We can also just copy and paste right out of the Froala editor. There's also a full screen mode here, so we can go into full screen just to focus on our work. One other thing I want to point out is they do have an undo redo button, so we can quickly revert back to our changes if we would like. So this is making the editor super, super dynamic. Okay, so the next thing that I am going to show you is how to connect this button that has been added into the Froala editor. And one thing else I want to point out is that you can add custom buttons in the Froala editor that do certain things. And they also have a bunch of different plugins. So check out their website for all kinds of different plugins. Some of them may require to be on a pro version or paid, but you could do a lot with their free HTML editor as I'm showing you here. Okay, so what I'm gonna go ahead and do is I'm gonna connect my OpenAI key. I'm gonna go off screen to do this. And then once I connect that here, I'm gonna show you how we can integrate ChatGPT, OpenAI right into this editor. Okay, so what I did is I navigated to a tab here within Replit called Secrets. And all I needed to do was post my OpenAI key in secret here within the secret section of the Replit app. And it saves these as secure environment variables so they're not exposed on the front end. But you have to paste in your OpenAI key. And then what you can do is we can come back to the preview and we can go ahead and give this button a try, which is the ChatGPT assistant. generate AI content. Now, what we ideally want to have happen here is we can use AI to sort of get us a kickstart on whatever we're going to be writing here for our automated AI content creation, and then we can add elements with the Froala editor. So let's go ahead and click this. And what's really nice is this is all within this one editor document. You don't have external tools. It really streamlines your workflow. So we click AI and check this out. We have a pop-up module that allows us to type in something here, a blog post about the future of marketing with AI tools. Okay, that sounds pretty good. And then what we can actually do is enter our target SEO keywords. So we could say AI, SEO, marketing maybe, LLMs, okay. That should be good. Of course, this is a super basic example, but we're also able to specify what kind of content do we want. Do we have bullet points, an outline, summary, full article? Let's just go ahead and say full article. How long do we want it? Long 800 words. And who's our target audience? Is it technical, beginners, industry experts? Let's say business professionals. And then we can actually choose the tone for the article. And since we connected our OpenAI key, we can just go ahead and hit generate content, and this should work. Keep in mind, we didn't do a ton of setup here, so this is pretty basic integration with OpenAI into Froala, but it just shows you how easy it is with these dev agents like Replit or Lovable or whatever you're using. Okay, so that just took a second, and check this out. We have this article that was written for us. So we just built a super powerful internal tool that can help us write blog posts. But as you would expect with AI, you're sort of just getting the text. There's not a lot of formatting. So this is where Froala really comes in handy, because we're using AI within the editor. We could simply start to make edits to our document right here in line. We can bold the titles if we would like. We can add images. If we want to put a little table in here with a chart breakdown, we can do that. Let's just put that in. We can add spacing. We can also hit this plus button to add images, videos, tables, unordered lists, ordered lists, horizontal lines, and so much more. So we can just come through really quickly and we can edit our article all within the Froala editor here, right within our AI application. So you're building internal tools or external tools, whatever it may be. Having this really powerful rich text editor in your application is huge, because this would take a long time to build and you'd have to worry about things like storing the data, but Froala handles all of that for you. Not only do they have this powerful CDN, but they also have a powerful API, and you can even download all the files locally to your machine. I'm not going to go through and edit the rest of this document, but I think you get the idea. Really easy to add spacing, image, videos, rich text, and you can even add additional widgets and buttons, like I mentioned earlier, right into your Froala editor. So yeah, in just about 15 minutes, we spun up a application. You could publish this to your own domain, and it's a powerful internal tool to generate AI SEO friendly content with specific target keywords for SEO purposes, as well as choosing your tone and your target audience and the style of content that you want to create. I hope this was helpful. I can't wait to see what you build with Replit and Froala. If you have any questions, again, drop them below. Like this video if you enjoyed it, and please subscribe to our channel so you don't miss any other videos like this one. Okay, thank you so much.